So what is up, everybody? My name is the Shig, and welcome back to Batman, the Telltale series, because it doesn't have an official title other than that. Alright, so we're done episode 1. A lot of stuff went down. We took down Valcone, we met up with Catwoman. So, not too much serious, but definitely pulled us into the story there. There's some sort of crowd play, I don't know what that is. I'm not gonna turn that on, because I don't have a clue what that means, so we're just gonna go straight in now with episode 2. Previously on Batman, the Telltale series. Oh, I didn't need to do a recap, huh?
What happened? A revolution is knocking on Gotham's door. When this whole thing starts, make sure you're on the right side.
I will do, Mr. Copperpot.
Mr. Wayne, thank you for opening your house to us.
Pretty sure this happened before, Cobblepot.
We will change Gotham.
And that is Mr. Dent.
Harvey Dent, Gotham's next mayor, and eager to know you.
Vicki Vale, not interested, and reporter for the Gotham Gazette. Carmine Falcone? Is the Dent campaign soliciting votes from Gotham's biggest crime family?
Everyone knows him as a crime family. I guess they got ways around getting convicted.
Don't you know not to corner a wild animal?
Man, this
it's
is
dangerous.
Quite the big previously. It really is summing up everything.
Bye, Bat.
This is Selina.
How many?
I'd have to count the pieces.
Man, this is a long ass previously. I've already said that, but still, let's just drag it out a little bit now.
Where are they?
We're all being played here, including you. Christ Almighty!
It's the Waynes.
Well, the Waynes are the biggest gangsters in Gotham.
He doesn't know what he's talking about. Or does he? But there's only Bruce. How could they be the biggest gangsters in there if there's one guy, and he is Batman? So he's definitely not doing any sort of crime, so that doesn't make any sense. Ah, here we go. Alright, what is going down? Are we picking up right off where we left from the last night? Was that Falcone? It must have been when we were hanging him out through the window. Or the window that we made with our drone or whatever it was that happened. Are we Wayne? Oh, is this the alley his parents got shot on? Is that a memorial on the floor? I believe it is.
Master Bruce.
Thomas and Martha Wayne. Who's that, Alfred? Man, it is 5:30 in the morning. What am I doing up this time?
I thought
this
I might
is called Crime Alley. Amazing.
The news was upsetting for both of us.
I think it'd be more so for Mr. Wayne. He saw that happen.
I know you come here for solitude, Bruce.
More allegations about his ties to the underworld.
Well,
this isn't going away.
It's all so public and messy.
People are throwing stones at my family, Alfred. I need to understand why.
It's my family too. Don't forget that.
Sorry, Alfred. Please don't get mad at me.
I've been dreading this day for nearly 2 decades. I hoped
Wait.
It would never come.
Forget
you
the
you
news.
Knew about this?
I want to hear it from you.
The truth is, they were billionaires, Bruce. You can't amass that kind of wealth without making certain moral compromises. It's just not possible. That kind of money taints you.
You kept their secrets for them.
I'm trying to help you understand.
Then try harder!
Ooh, we just need to chill out, guys. We can definitely settle this a bit more civil without all of the shouting.
Hill was the wheels of politics. Falcone was the muscle. Thomas legitimized the whole enterprise with his name. Your father, Hamilton Hill, and Falcone, they were partners.
Damn it.
Nothing happened in Gotham without them knowing.
Let's go with this.
Working with Falcone and him. I expected a regular accounting, not a pact with the devil.
Your father was a good man in many ways, but this was his undoing. I want you to know, I had my suitcases ready. I couldn't stand to be around your father anymore. But then they were killed, and you were all alone. And I just couldn't walk out the door.
Yeah, you almost left, huh?
Everything I've ever done was out of love for you.
It's okay, Alfred.
You can forgive me.
I would forgive him. He seems so genuine. We're still family. I'm not ready. You let me down. Don't go with this one.
This against you.
It's quite the emotional little entrance there.
I won't let you down again.
It's cool, man. We cool. Could never be mad at Alfred.
This is the first time I've been back here since that night. When the police called me to collect you, I thought they'd finally arrested your father.
Oh.
I couldn't believe a low-life thug like Joe Chill would have the audacity to rob and kill Thomas Wayne. He was simply too well known. Too big.
What, the criminal or Thomas?
Yet, there it was.
Let's go with this.
Chill just run when he recognized him.
Well, it's a fair assumption.
But he didn't.
You always said it was a simple mugging. In 20 years, you've never wavered from that story.
I can recall every moment of that night in vivid detail.
But maybe detail.
That's why. Nice. Sometimes
I would have went with detail, but
we don't want to face.
Maybe there was some detail I overlooked.
Oh, he's changing up on the pronunciation of detail. Amazing. Oh, okay. We're just gonna have a look around the alley. It's been 20 years. You think, why is this loading real slowly? What is going on, guys? What is going on? I can't walk up the curve. Okay, I'll just look at the wall then.
I want him standing here. Right now.
And what would the Batman do with his own parents' killer? The possibilities are frightening.
Does Jail kill him? Ask him why. I guess Batman would send it to jail.
Just like any other criminal.
But he's not just any criminal, is he?
Yeah, but Batman, I got morals, man. I can't go around killing people.
He was stabbed to death in prison. No one mourns for Joe Chill, Bruce.
Well, whatevs, Alfred, whatevs. At least he's not at large. So why is this really laggy? What is going on?
He just wanted to protect us.
He thought he was invincible. Sadly, he was mistaken.
I can't picture him as a criminal. Not the kind I deal with.
In that moment, he was simply your father.
I wonder if this story has been touched on by the comic books. Alright, we'll look at the fair to the last. I just want to see if there's anything up this end of the alley. Oh, I can talk to Alfred. Nope, it looks like it is just talking to Alfred or looking at the theater. I'll talk to my man Alfred in a second. I'm just gonna go look at the theater. Walking over there nice slowly.
I love that movie. Saw it countless times at that theater. How long did it play there?
Only when you wanted to see it, Bruce. Your mother arranged the special screenings personally.
Did we own the theater then?
She was always so good to me.
Well, I don't get to talk to Alfred. No. Unless this is going to be the conversation that was going to happen.
With my father pleading, you don't have to do this. And the gun fires.
And after that? There are considerable gaps in that recollection.
Wait until I'm Maverick.
Maybe. Do I really want to know?
Probably not. Are we gonna do more detective work? Oh, why is it in a slow motion? Where are we walking to? Oh. He got us around the corner like that? I thought we were looking for the theater. All I can do is walk forward.
Stay back!
Take whatever you want!
Nothing personal. Just business. He told me you had it coming.
You don't have to do this.
Why does he kill him? But
don't fuck on me. He's making a mistake.
Oh, Fat Cody hired him as a hitman? Well, now that necklace is worthless, you jackass. Oh no. Not enough time
Bruce,
to pull the trigger, huh?
Right.
It wasn't a mugging.
It was a hit.
Assassinated. And Carmine Falcone knows why.
Well, sure kicked off with a bang, didn't it? That's hilarious. It's just like a horror movie. I got this player wired up.